The special guest of honor, the chairman of the commission, as well as His Excellency the Governor and his lovely wife. Photographers, please take your shots and move away very fast. Take your shots and move away. Chairman of please let's welcome His Excellency General Abdulsalami Abubakar Jizia Faro, former head of state of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Shall we please put hands together for him? Your Excellencies, photographers, take your shots.
In Yenagoa, giving them a way of life comparable to any anywhere in Nigeria, indeed in West Africa, Africa and the world. The new Yenagoa city is aspirational. We will need to love, learn to love and protect it like other people around the world. This means adhering to physical planning laws, respecting public areas and public properties, and keeping our streets clean. The screen to my left shows the efforts of the restoration government that they have put in so far, taking in the golf course, the recently converted Castle Hotel, and I have to say I've seen Bayelsans from far and wide marvel at this jewel hidden behind Government House. With this launch, we will pull back the veil. Finally, for the doubters, I leave you with a picture, if I can come up. In the center is a picture of Abuja Hilton in 1997. Granted, the city of Abuja was created with federal might, but let us not forget that Bayelsa resources contributed significantly to that development. It's now time to develop our own. At that point, today we invite the world to visit, to invest, and stay in the new Yenagoa city. Welcome, Ado Nwa.
Jonathan, His Excellency, the Honorable Henry Seriake Dickson, Governor of Bayelsa State, and his wife, Dr. Rachel Seriake Dickson. A Right Honorable Tonye Isena, Speaker of the House of Bayelsa State, the House of Assembly of Bayelsa State, Chief Judge of Bayelsa State, Honorable Justice Kate Abiri. Ladies and gentlemen, please kindly allow me to rest on already established protocol. I'm delighted to be here with you today for the official launch of the new Yenagoa city. Since the inception of Restoration Government in 2012, the Governor of Bayelsa State, the Honorable Henry Seriake Dickson, has recognized that development of the physical environment is critical in both attracting people and investment to Bayelsa State. Today marks an important milestone in bringing his vision of a safe, well-planned and serene community to life. Aside from targeted current and future investments in roads, bridges, security, power, the new Yenagoa city is already host to a myriad of other amenities. These include the Bayelsa Golf Course, which is an 18-hole PGA Championship course due to open by the end of this year, the Castle Hotel, the former Governor's Lodge converted to a 19-suite luxury boutique hotel opened in 2018, the Bayelsa Polo Club with its 300 by 150 foot grass pitch with a 200-seater stand and modern stables, the Bayelsa Golf Estate, a planned 200-home estate nestled within the heart of the golf course, and last but not least, the GRA. This initial phase is 1,218 generously sized plots offered to the public on a strict policy of one man, one plot, which is already 90% subscribed. Primary access to this area will be open later this year with the completion of the Onoka Bridge. I would add that we do have plots available for the GRA and the Gulf Estate, and we invite everyone here to please pick up an expression of interest from in the lobby. To show all our invited guests some of the developments in the new Yenagoa city, we would like to show you a short video.
His Excellency, General Islam Abubakar GCFR, former President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. His Excellency, Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, GCFR, former President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Excellency, the Honorable Henry Seriake Dickson, Governor of Bayelsa State, I did need to stand on existing protocols. First, I want to say I'm the chairman of the Board of Trustees of his Job Professional Association, and not the president. The president is not here. I want to say that I'm delighted to be here to witness this occasion. As a professional organization, we believe we could add some value by working with the state government. So we decided to come around to make a tour of all the projects that the governor was doing, because we were hearing so much on the social media and we thought we should come and see for ourselves. And so we came down to the state, and the project committee in the state, we went around all these projects, including the road that has been constructed to link the southern Nigeria-Kano side. I was so happy and delighted that it's not only social media hype, it is an actual physical development of the ground. And we expressed our great pleasure to the governor that yes, we are happy. We even visited this very the golf course that was under construction. We even discussed with Funkasi then about the possibility of allocating all the plots there to people so I can facilitate the development of that golf course. But here we are today, that a whole GRA is coming on. I want to say we're very happy. I want to say congratulations, sir, to the governor and to his team. And I will look forward to when this project will physically and fully go on stream, and we'll be enjoying the new Bayelsa State. Thank you very much. God bless you.
With your permission, I will establish protocol. It's an honor to stand here as a partner and an investor in Bayelsa State, especially in the area of agriculture, and with quite a lot of experience in developing new communities, such as Victoria Garden City in Lagos in the past. Seeing this here is amazing. And I would like to say that it's not only me, it's our group, and there is a lot of other investors who are just waiting for the green light to come and invest in this beautiful new community. Today I checked in at the Castle Hotel. I remember this building when it was built. Your Excellency, I must say, wow. Wow. That is the only thing I can say. And to all you Bayelsans, I mean, you should just be proud. And of course, we are investing, we will continue to invest after February as well. And I love you Bayelsans, that's what I can say.
Your Excellency, former Head of State of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, General Abdusalam Abubakar. Your Excellency, former President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan. Your Excellency, the Executive Governor of Bayelsa State, Right Honorable Henry Seriake Dickson. Permit me, if you will, to sit beside the existing protocol, because if I stand on it, it will probably collapse. But let me also recognize my friend and brother, former Governor of River State, retired General Anthony Ubo. headquartered the Global Intermonetary Board is headquartered here in Bayelsa State. And as an agency of the federal government, we are committed to working with the administration in Bayelsa State, as well as the developmental strides of the government of Bayelsa State. And my goodwill message is very short. It is to tell His Excellency the Governor and people of Bayelsa State that whatever developmental agenda that you are committed to, as NCDFB, we are partners in progress. And we are committed to working with you in realizing this project that you have started. We will continue to be here as an agency of government, which of course was established and brought in by the former president to be in Bayelsa State. And it is the only federal, solid federal establishment that we have in the state. We will adorn the skyline very soon with our 17-story headquarters building, which in itself will be commissioned before the end of this year. I think people say it will be the tallest building in the south-south and southeast after the one that was built by the former governor of Old River State, His Royal Majesty Alfred Yetespeef. So it was built 40 years ago by a Bayelsa, a River State. This other one will also be built by a Bayelsa in Bayelsa State. So Your Excellency, we are committed to working with you to realize the objective of this project. Thank you very much.
Come up with a PGA true to type, as they say, the Tokaduno governor. Hey, here we are. We have a golf course here in Yenagoa. I tell you, university might be one thing we're talking about, but also we are developing seaports down in Agay, in Brass, Akasa. All those are beautiful tourist sites also. And these are things which the governor has been pursuing diligently with the little funds at his disposal. So, frankly, just like I said the day I was called to make my first and maiden speech, I was still in Lagos at the time, and I said, we too have lived to see the creation of River State. The many who fought for it and never saw it. And now I can equally say, we too have lived to see this marvelous thing that has happened here in Bayelsa. So to the governor and the resolution team, I'll say congratulations. And all the aspirants, please take note. Golf is a magnetic, an investor magnetic thing. And I wish you all well and hope that by the time you go back to your various destinations, you will always see, even when you close your eyes, see Bayelsa and the moon. Thank you very much. Before I take my seat, I'd like to specially thank His Excellency General Absalom for making time to come and spend this week with us. Billy Jonathan. He is not just of Nigeria, he's a world citizen. We are very proud of him. Keep the flag flying. And to you all who are here to praise this occasion, thank you again for coming and God bless you.
About 200 hectares of land set aside for residences. And then you also have the golf estate, which is more luxurious. That is finished homes, which people will be opportune to buy. So you're not just buying land, you're buying homes that are finished to very high quality.
Development here in New Yenagoa City is really about offering people the type of lifestyle that will encourage investors to come here to know that they have the right type of workforce so that they can invest in people, that they will stay here. Bayelsas themselves, wherever they may be, know that they can come and that they can have the kind of lifestyle that they can find anywhere in the world right here at home.
We have many people that come in, perhaps just for some days of the week, and they don't spend weekends here. But with a development of this nature, it gives people a reason to think of living in Yenagoa as opposed to just passing through Yenagoa because they have no choice. And because of the safety that is guaranteed by this secluded and very serene environment.
So we have a large corner plot for the Army. We have a large corner plot for the Air Force. We have a large corner plot for the Navy, and so on and so forth. DSS is there then. So this will be their base. In fact, it's a home gated island. It will be a place where there are security, where there is leisure, where there is fun, where there's places for conference centers. And so that's what we wanted to create.
The people who have the money that want to come and invest find that they don't have where to recreate and how to also relax, then they might not make it their home. They just come in, invest and go. But if it is homely enough, provided on the golf or program, you know, flying clubs and other activities, they will now come and stay and make it their home.
That's why the government has set up the new Yenagoa City Development Agency. It's going to be controlled, there are standards, there are rules, this estate, the cables have to be underground and all of that. So you're going to have a development that you can be proud of, that is comparative to whatever you find everywhere else. Giving people a completely different mindset, seeing themselves in a different environment, picturing themselves differently, realizing and accepting that Bayelsans do have the right to enjoy the very best of everything. When you feel that you have the right to enjoy the best of everything, even your self-esteem changes.
We have put into a custom everything in one place. And so the uniqueness of this island is that you have of working, living, entertainment, leisure, medical, that's all
important. That meet my needs or people who are trying to attract Bayelsa. And also Bayelsa that team outside the country, that team in other parts of Nigeria, also get them to overcome and have means back at home that they have outside Bayelsa.
And so we should support it wholeheartedly and we should learn in a new ways of life instead of sticking to old ways of life.
We had to be. And as it will go.
Come into this place with an open mind and blow away. Because Bayelsa, with this particular project, has taken us as a state way, way, way up the ladder.
Between now and 2025 years, I think this is going to be the most important real estate development in this state. Upon completion, it will be to compare to any other one anywhere else.
At this point, to invite, to make his remarks, no other person than the one whom God has chosen, whom God gave the foresight to develop a new grand city for Yenagoa and indeed Bayelsa State. I'm talking about no other person than the Antonio Nadu Governor, His Excellency, Honorable Henry Seriake Dickson, and our teams who are here.
nation who today is here with us in this occasion as chairman. Please, a round of applause for him. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for finding time to be here to share this occasion. Let me also recognize another leader and father, and also what I always say, my elder brother too, our leader, former president of this great nation, His Excellency Dr. Goodluck Jonathan. Who is here in several capacities, first as a Bayelsa in his own right. Round of applause. Is here a special guest of honor. Thank you for always supporting good things and good development and initiatives in our state. My dear wife, former governor of Old River State and chairman of the Council of Traditional Rulers, who is also the royal father of today. Let me recognize all the leaders of the various arms, because the protocol list is very long today. I recognize all of you at the various levels of the government of our state. But let me take in a cue from what His Majesty said, especially recognize the Royal Fathers of our state, Your Royal Majesties and Highnesses. And underscore the fact that in this state we recognize and appreciate the great work that you all do as custodians of the culture and fathers of our land. Our friends who are visiting from near as well as from far, thank you very much for your show of friendship and brotherhood. Service commanders, and all of you who are here, the beautiful, extra beautiful women of Bayelsa. My brothers and friends, seeing them all, aspirants who are just in to take over from me. So a number of them, and they are seated together. A round of applause for all of them. That is the Bayelsa spirit. That is the Bayelsa spirit. Gentlemen of the press, very distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Bayelsa Noir! Bayelsa Noir! Bayelsa Noir! Bayelsa Noir! A lot has been said about this monumental project that we are unveiling today. And let me begin by using this opportunity on behalf of the government and the good people of this great state to once again warmly welcome and receive into our midst our chairman of this occasion and former head of state of our nation and the leading consensus builder and promoter of peace in our nation, General Abdusalam Abubakar, GCFA, into our midst. Thank you very much. Let me also recognize those who came with you as part of your entourage, including our former governor. He retired as a general in our nation's army, but we all know him here as Colonel Ugbo. Thank you, General Ugbo, and the other members of the entourage who are here. We are welcome to a state of great people, of good and wonderful people. But you are also welcome to a state of big dreams. And these big dreams, some of them predated me. There are so many stories we don't have time for. But in the last 7.5 years, we have been consolidating on these big dreams and expanding. pushing the frontiers of development in all sectors. Today we are not assembled here to talk about the schools that we have built everywhere. We are not here to talk about the hospitals that are everywhere. We are not talking about the roads and bridges. It's very difficult to make. If we had time, we would have just tracked behind here for 5 minutes to look at the bridge across Donopa. Donopa Bridge across this, the big lake. That in the next 1 or 2 months will be finished for completion. That's the road, the bridge that will take everybody straight to this dream island. So a lot is going on. You are also here today to be part of this history, the development of the new Yenagoa City. And I like the way His Majesty put it. New York City now has a more modern counterpart. New Yenagoa City, all of them NYC. And our own NYC is more modern and better, and so it shall be in Jesus' name. And it takes a lot of hard work, the dream and the vision are just nothing. And I want to call on all of us to be part of it. I'm very encouraged. All of my team, a team of very hardworking men as well as women. And you've listened to some of our wonderful, beautiful, brilliant ladies. And a friend just whispered to me, he said, Governor, why is it that all the ladies, all your key people who spoke here, ladies, what happened? And I said, well, one of the secrets you'll find out today in Bayelsa is that our women are not only beautiful, our women are brilliant. Not in the other room. Our women take center stage, not in the other room. And I said, look, our brilliant women, you just seen the tip of the iceberg. But the other thing is that before the gentlemen complain, I also want to say that the men are also in control. Brilliant women, the men are in control. But we are all working as a team. Elders, youth, as you can see in this hall. And that is the real promise of our state. A state that is at peace with itself. Don't mind what people say because of politics. This state is at peace with itself. This state is united for development. This state is together working for development and stability and prosperity of our people. And I welcome you all to participate in this great vision. The posts that the ladies talked about are offered. There's no discrimination whatsoever. I signed CFOs for every person who applied. By the way, one of the earliest things we did as a government was to bring the same people who set up the Abuja aging system. And they came here to build a system for us. And since 2013 in this state, if you make an investment in real estate, it doesn't take too long for the computerized system to process it for me to sign. And we don't care whose name is on the certificates. By the same program, the same values of tolerance and inclusion that we have built upon in this state. This estate is available for every Bayelsa who desires to own a plot here, irrespective of political persuasion. I want to make that very clear. This estate is also open for all our people, all the jobs, living anywhere in this country and outside, feel free to come and invest. After all, in this government, we have referred to our state as the Jerusalem of the generation. So feel free to invest. And all Nigerians of goodwill who want to live in peace, in harmony, and in prosperity. You are all welcome to Bayelsa. And that's why we say all good human beings are first from Bayelsa. First from Bayelsa. They don't talk about what Nigerians like to talk about, the state of origin. So what we care is a good person, then you must be a Bayelsa. And this estate is available for people to come and invest, for business and to live. Here we don't have land for Uga. We have land for development like this. We have land for development like this. So I invite all of you and all people of Uga. Now, there are some guidelines I've given to the team. Land has been approved that plots will be allocated to all former presidents and heads of states of our country who mean well for us and whose lives and activities have impacted on our people. We begin it with the CFO of the plots, Waterfront. Waterfront, this is the only state where you get waterfront properties as beautiful as this. This is the Florida period. So if there's anyone out there who wants a waterfront, creek view residence, where else to come to? And by us, the glory of our land. This is part of the glory of our land. So we'll make some of those presentations. Our chairman of occasion, for what he has presented and the friendships he has built, we will have these presented. And our president, our leader and father, President Goodluck Emele Jonathan, GCFR, automatically presented. With his dear wife also presented. All former governors of this state, all former governors, it doesn't matter the party that you now currently belong to, or the partisan battles and squabbles that some of us have been party to for the past over 10 years. We are talking about Bayelsa. Bayelsa, not party, no differences. We will sign, I will sign this year for some of them have already signed. But we have also said that all the services, all our brothers and sisters and friends, fellow Nigerians, putting on our nation's colors, doing their best, working with our government and with our people to keep our state, our region, and our country safe, we are making allocations, generous allocations to them in this new city. This new city. Some of the allocations and CFOs are ready. And I will also present them. So this is a way of adding to what the beautiful ladies have said, and to further use this opportunity to invite the investing public, invite our friends, and all those who desire to be part of not just our development, but all those who also want to live in a luxury, peaceful, serene, waterfront environment within Nigeria. You don't need to travel to Florida. You don't need to travel far to other places and find out whether visas are granted or not granted, depending on who is president of when. You come to the great state of Bayelsa, the state that is at peace, the settled, and the state that is open for investment. You have heard about the facilities there, the hospitals, the hotels, the golf course that will be commissioned later this year. You have heard about the polo field that is there. And then the golf estates, serene estates within the golf course. And there are not many places you have this type of beautiful developments like that. So all of these are available, and I invite you all to express interest and to be part of it. I've directed that those that are left, some of them, depending on the interest that people register, some should be left so that the next government coming next year will continue and begin to build on what we have started. I invite you all to be part of this great development. I congratulate all of us in Bayelsa. Once again, I thank you all for your continued friendship, for your support, and your prayers. I pray that all of us will join hands to continue to build a more stable, a safer, and a prosperous Bayelsa for ourselves and for generations on board. Thank you very much for coming, and God bless you all.
His Excellency the Governor, having made his remarks, will now be signing some of the certificates of occupation, certificates of occupancy, which of course will be presented to some of the beneficiaries. Is signing the global CFO for the new Yenagoa city. Of course, you can see the managing director of the new Yenagoa City Development Agency, Amy Falloway, standing right beside the governor. And of course, observing with keen interest.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, your excellencies, what I've just done is to transfer the totality of the titles over all this land we have been talking about, called the new Yenagoa City, away from governmental control, and to vest it in a private sector driven vehicle for management, of which this beautiful, brilliant lady is the managing director. So governments come, government go. The title of the whole area is vested in this agency, and it is from this overall composite title that she will give titles to all investors, and also be vested with the duties of managing, controlling the development, enforcing order, as I've done by the laws I've signed. Congratulations, Amy.
The governor formally presents the CFO to the managing director of the Union University Development Agency. He will sit back to sign other CFOs. Of course, it's been guided by the managing director of Pages, Sylvia Igor Coyne. He is now going to sign that of NNS Toro, and I'd like to invite the commander, Commander Sehile, to please step forward.
Protecting our nation's maritime domain. And it has now become the responsibility of states to give access to land for the installation of these security facilities, which you now call Falcon Eye.
to support our national security. And so I'm presenting two stay of holds, or two certificates of occupancy. One for a new naval base called NNS Sorrow. Again, use this opportunity to commend the leadership of the Nigerian Navy for appreciating the sacrificing contributions of our own dear Admiral M.B. Sorrow, whose name is Obambia. So I would like to present this for NNS Sorrow Base, located strategically at the outer side of this new university development, both for security and for everything. Congratulations.
CFO for NNS Sora, being presented to the commander, Navy Commodore Isaiah.
Please, with all due respect, would like to invite Rear Admiral SS Garba to collect that of the Falcon Eye, Koloma. Thank you.
SS Garba is a flag officer commanding the Central Naval Command of the Nigerian Navy based here in Yenagoa. CFO for Falcon Eye in Nigerian Navy. And of course, just like His Excellency the Governor promised, there is also a land allocated to former presidents. It is my pleasure at this point to invite to step forward and receive the CFO, our own very distinguished son, a symbol of our democracy. President, good luck, Ebele Jonathan, GCFR.
Of the 16th Brigade of the Nigerian Army.
Let's please put hands together for Francis. Steps forward. Smartly, of course, walks towards His Excellency. A salute and a presentation. Brigade Commander's residence has to also be at the new Yenagoa setting. Congratulations. Next, I'd like to invite the Director of State Services, the Director of State Security Service, to step forward and receive his.
From all the six coastal states where our people reside,
Once you are at that level, you also have equal rights. Just approach the people and you have a plot of land. Thank you. We have given plots to the clergy, all leading clergymen in our country. We'll have plots here. So, Seriake, okay, you are representing him. Okay, congratulations.
Archbishop Seriake, the Chairman Christian Association of Nigeria, South South, will receive on behalf of Apostle David Seriake. CFO for the clergy. You can see the Managing Director of Pages, Savior Igor Goy. Give a supporting hand to His Excellency, Governor, as he makes the presentation to Archbishop.
By special demand from my MD, may I invite Chief Ephraim Fallon. Your daughter, your beautiful daughter, says I must present your own to you before I go down.
Smith steps forward to receive his own CFO for a plot at the new Yenagoa setting. Anything worth doing is worth doing well, and that has informed His Excellency's decision to handle this aspect of the program itself. Ephraim Fallowy receives his. Well, for want of time, of course, His Excellency will sign and present others later. Let's please put hands together for His Excellency, the Governor of Bayelsa State.
Now, with great pleasure, I invite to speak to this august gathering the man who embodies humility, a man who served Bayelsa State in a capacity as deputy governor, and then governor, and then vice president, and then president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Unity and development. Please join me in receiving His Excellency, Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, GCOM-GCFR.
Chairman of this occasion, former head of state, General Islamic Baka. Thank you for coming. Let me appreciate the governor and the wife for bringing us here today. Let me also appreciate the royal father of the day, the former military governor of the Old River State, who is now the chairman of the Bayelsa State Council of Traditional Rulers, King Alfred Wakuyede HSP. Thank you for coming. The Right Honourable Speaker, as members of the National Assembly, the Right Honourable Speaker, members of the State Assembly, the Chief Judge of Bayelsa State, like Governor was talking about, the role women play in Bayelsa State, our Chief Judge, also a lady. The members of our team, the service commanders, the Commissioner of Police, the State Director of Security, and other senior military people that are here with us. Let us especially appreciate Senator Mantu and others, my good friends who came from Abuja, my brothers and sisters. I'm quite excited today, so I pray that we'll labor your ears a little because of the unique occasion, even though we have stayed for quite some time, so I'll try and summarize my statement. But I'll start from one of the video clips that the presenter showed us when they were constructing Hilton in Abuja. And I remember one of the Minister of National Planning is to tell us two stories about when you have occasions like this, when you want to venture into certain situations. And he used Hilton as one of the examples. The first time Hilton was to be constructed, that place was literally swampy in Abuja. And some of the first set of engineers and architects felt but how will you build a hotel here? Who will be here? But some of that will have a better and greater vision. They felt that place was good for health. And of course now, that is the center of Abuja. And I also give another example of a particular area where people don't wear shoes. And the company said their marketing manager to go to that place and see if they will have investment. The manager went back to the company and said that look, those people don't use shoes, so we have no business there. That company left. Another company sent their own marketing manager and went to that area. And they got back to his company and said that we have big business in that place. We have to introduce those people to use of shoes. They will appreciate it and it will grow. And of course, it did. I'm saying so because sometimes when you look at some of the newly created states like Bayelsa State was a part of, when we were in the Old River State, it was the rural part of the Old River State, General Rupo will agree with me. And sometimes you feel that no, you cannot bring Nigeria to that place. As long as leaders of the state have dreams and visions. And if you also know, look at the history of Dubai, that every Nigerian lady wants to go to Dubai. Somewhere that was almost like a piece of desert. And now it's like the world market. Then you see that a place like Bayelsa has a lot of potential. So I'm happy today, and I'm indeed pleased with the governor of the state for this presentation. I came in as the deputy governor to GDSL as I mentioned, so I have an idea about what every other governor has planned to do before we get to this level that we have reached. Lamesi also initiated, remember we had some survey plans done by Aldo, building up on Aduke's platform, but we didn't go too far. I was here for not quite 1 year, 6 months, about 1 year, 5 months, some weeks. I also contacted one company from South Africa. We had robust discussions, and I remember that time, because of the briefing I gave to President Obasanjo, he instructed that them who were still sober, RFI was the Minister of FCT, I instructed that RFI, whenever he wants to come to Bayelsa State, should not even bother to take permission. He should just come, because they have to help me to see how we can develop the Yenagoa city. Of course, I left almost immediately. So the dream continued, and today I'm quite pleased that Dickson, who was also one of the number one commissioners in my cabinet, then was then the Attorney General, has made this come true. So I have to thank you and members of your team and the ladies that made the fantastic presentations, and that is the way to go. I still believe as long as our leaders have dreams and have visions, it will not take us more than 25 years when we come to Yenagoa or Bayelsa State, they will be marvel. It depends on one government taking over from the other one and building on to certain good things. Of course, the new government must make changes, modify certain things, but not to abandon good ones. And what's our our investor died, his relief son of Bayelsa State said it's very instructive. He made a simple statement that he will live beyond February. And probably we will just push it aside. That statement is very, very significant. Because we know that Governor Dickson will complete his 8 years of service by middle of February. So some investors may be afraid after February what will happen. Will the new governor carry on with what Dickson started? The luck I have today is that when I came in, I look at the faces, and I'm very hopeful that the next governor of the state must be in this hall too, or probably. Probably watching this program from somewhere, or watch the program. It's a good and a noble project that we will all collectively make sure that the new leadership of the state carry on with this kind of project. So once again, on behalf of my wife too, I have to thank the governor for giving us a CFO, one for myself and one for my wife. And also the other 4 years of state that you will give was Abdulslam too. Thank you. We also thank you on behalf of those of them who are not here physically with us. I wish the governor and his team success, and I wish Bayelsa State better development as we progress. I thank you all.
That has been Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, a very unique personality, rose through the political ranks, deputy governor, governor, vice president, and president. At this point, I'd like to invite, with utmost respect and humility, to make his own remarks, the man who is still building bridges of peace and unity across our country. Yes, one of the military heads of states that willingly added over power to civilian rule. Let's please put them together for the chairman of this occasion, General Abdulsalami Abubakar, GCFR, former head of state of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Let's once again put hands together for him as he approaches the podium.
Thank you. Please be seated. Your Excellency, the former president, Your Excellency, the governor and your beautiful wife, our royal fathers, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Let me first start by thanking His Excellency for inviting me to this auspicious occasion. Indeed, it is very, very delighting to come and see the work you have been doing for the last 8 years. I was talking to my friend when we were coming here that I can't believe that Bayelsa and Yenagoa will grow to the state I have seen it today. I would like to say without any contradiction that Yenagoa is one of the fastest developing cities in the new state. And I want to congratulate you and all those pioneers who have done the groundwork to make this city what is coming to be. Your Excellency, your vision of NYC, New Yenagoa State City, and this is indeed a laudable one. May your visions come true. Your Excellency, let me, on behalf of all the people who are congratulate you and your team for your vision. It is indeed a vision, and it will come true. Let me again, on behalf of all the president, former presidents, for the surprise gift of this parcel of land in the waterfront. We thank you. When you were making that announcement, I was talking to my brother, and then good luck, that I hope our plots will be co-joined so that we can make a case in between our houses. So, Your Excellency, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I want to again thank you for giving me the opportunity to share this occasion.
So this is the Golden State and the Bayelsa 18 hole championship golf course. As we said, we'll be open, the golf course will be open until the end of this year. And as you can see, we have lakes, we have plots that are over 1,000 square meters each. And it's going to be a wonderful, peaceful, serene place to live, play, and look for the golf. And this is the golf estate, and over this end,
his goodness. above our lives. May his name be glorified forever in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I will go quickly to acknowledge and appreciate two prominent citizens in our midst. We have one, His Excellency General Adosalami Abubakar. Also, our father, our political mentor, His Excellency Dr. Gulon Ebele Jonathan. I want to appreciate and thank both of you for your solidarity to the Bayelsa project and also being here physically with us to witness and celebrate this event. Let me also quickly appreciate the Toknadu, governor of Bayelsa State. His Excellency, Seriake Dickson. I want to say that we have a new university, a city that can be compared to any other city in the world. I want to appreciate you and thank you. The legacy we are keeping behind, I know posterity will never forget you. Thank you for changing the narrative. And also let me pick your heart. We all know that the administration, government is winding up. There are a few months to go. But let me appeal to you that whatever thing you will do to still have value to this project, Excellency, I think that do not hesitate. But there are a lot of things, there are a lot of farmers who can do a lot of things. Thank you, our neighbor, Dr. Du, Governor. Also, let me appreciate Her Excellency, the First Lady of Bayelsa State, for all what you are doing for Bayelsa State and your support to our Excellency. I thank you and appreciate you. I know that the Deputy Governor is not here, but I would like to appreciate him. Depending on Allah. I want to appreciate the Deputy Governor for this project, for his supportive role in seeing this project come to see the light of the day. Also, let me appreciate members of the National Assembly that I am. There are many here in their numbers. I am seeing Senator Doitri, Richard Paul, we have friend Obua here, and we have also one of them that I am, I want to thank you, especially. Also, we have former members of the National Assembly. I'm seeing Senator Matu, he's seated there. I want to appreciate you for coming to celebrate with us.